One of America's aging bridges is in pieces right now, and it's raising safety concerns all across the United States. Two cars wound up in a frigid river when the bridge collapsed in Washington State last night, and we're hearing gripping accounts from a survivor and witnesses, and we're also learning more about what went wrong. CNN's Dan Simon is joining us now from Mount Vernon in Washington State. That's right outside of Seattle. What do we know right now, Dan?
Well, first of all, the question that many folks have in this community is how something like this could happen. How could a semi-truck making contact with this bridge cause a major chunk of it to collapse? But I have to tell you, given everything that we've seen in Oklahoma and all the heartbreak and misery there, people here feel fortunate knowing that it could have been much, much worse. It happened after rush hour. The bridge was nearly empty.
Riverside Bridge over I-5 just collapsed. We have vehicles in the water.
One of those vehicles, a pickup, belonged to a couple heading on a camping trip. Dan Sligh was driving.
I saw the bridge start to fall at that point. Forward momentum just carried us right over. And as you saw the water approaching, it's just one of those, you hold on as tight as you can. And just a white flash and cold water. It was definitely cold this time of the year.
Sligh tells Seattle's Cairo TV the fall dislocated his shoulder. Worse, he couldn't get a response from his wife.
Popped my shoulder back in so I could unbuckle everything and get over to her. Unbuckled her, pulled her over into my side, which had less water because it was filling up about belly deep.
The Slighs eventually were rescued and taken to a hospital. Onlookers crowded by the side of the river and watched as searchers made sure no victims had been overlooked. In the end, only three people went into the water. They'll be okay. Nobody died.
I think it's amazing that there were only a handful of people on the bridge. It's typically heavily used. And so I think we're very fortunate.
During the night, police said part of an oversized load on a tractor trailer hit a bridge support girder, leading to the collapse. Dale Ogden tells Seattle's King 5 he saw it happen.
I saw the truck strike the corner, upper right corner of the bridge. It almost tipped the truck over, but it came back down. It tipped it up to about a 30-degree angle to the left, and it came back down on its wheels. And almost instantaneously behind that, I saw girders falling in my rearview mirror.
The big truck didn't go into the water. State police questioned the driver, but he wasn't detained. Today, plenty of people are getting a firsthand look at the twisted wreckage of the bridge. The Federal Highway Administration listed it as functionally obsolete, meaning it was old and narrow and not up to modern standards. Well, authorities estimate it's going to take $15 million to fix this bridge. They don't know how long it's going to take, weeks, maybe even months. This is going to be a major inconvenience, Wolf, for the people who live in this area. This is a major roadway accommodating about 71,000 vehicles each and every day. Wolf?
Dan Simon on the scene for us. Thank you. Let's talk to a man now who arrived at the scene of the collapse soon after it happened and shot some exclusive video. Richard Dessin is joining us now from Seattle. Richard, thanks very much. Walk us through what happened. When did you know something was terribly wrong?
Well, sir, my friend Alex Goins and I were just heading back from Bellingham. We had taken that freeway up north and were coming south back down about 2 hours later, getting close to exit 229. And all of a sudden, the traffic just came to an absolute complete stop rapidly. We were there for about 5 minutes. We noticed truck drivers starting to get out and look. And then we started seeing EMS lights on the eastern side of the banks showing up. I had had a camera that I just got with a telephoto lens. We started looking through it, started seeing the onlookers. Next thing you know, they're taking us off the exit. And we saw just, literally, you know, 200 yards ahead of us, the bridge was gone. My friend and I decided that we saw the Home Depot parking lot. We immediately went down there and got up on the levee. And as soon as we got there is when we started seeing the sheriff beginning to show up and the rescue starting. And that's where all the photographs and the video you have is where I took about 105 photos of the rescue scenario. I mean, it was amazing. We watched the gentleman being removed from the pickup truck and being put in the sheriff's boat. Outstanding job on all the EMS, the way they did it, the way they approached the bridge. And just to see both lanes of the bridge were, I mean, how it was buckled in the water. I mean, thank goodness nobody was hurt. We found that out a little bit later as we were driving back away on the back roads. But, thank God it was the section that was close to the shore, because had it been the middle section of the bridge, I think it would have been a completely different story for the individuals. So I'm happy everybody was safe, and people can see the photographs of what the bridge looked like and the actual vehicles on it.
Yeah, we're showing our viewers the pictures that you took, the photos, the video. Richard, you know this area well. You know this bridge. How surprised were you to see that this, at least big chunk, huge chunk of this bridge was gone?
Very surprised. I mean, it was one of those irony moments where just 2 hours earlier we headed north on the section, and now, spinning around, heading south on it. We were up in Bellingham taking some pictures at the university, decided to stay for about an extra minute or so before we got on the freeway. Had we got on when we did, it could have been a whole different story for us as well, because we were right there close with that first group of vehicles. It's amazing. We had a lot of thoughts afterwards, a lot of what ifs for the next couple hours.
Richard Dessin, thanks so much for sharing your story. Thanks so much for sharing the video and the pictures, the still pictures as well. Richard Dessin,
yes,
joining
sir.
Us from Seattle. Still ahead, the woman at the center of the David Petraeus scandal gives her first interview about her affair with the former CIA chief. Stand by. And President Obama's oops moment today during a trip to give a graduation speech.